Then after a day or two, Baba said he was going to Quetta and that he will travel first, journey first to Quetta with the men, and we women have to come afterwards, after 2 days. Baba didn't want to travel with us women, so he went first. And so we were in charge of Gustadji, Meru's father, Rustam, and who was Naja's father, Masaji. Elderly, but he was robust. So anyway, we came to, Baba was in Bombay, and from Bombay, he was on his way to Quetta, and then we came to Bombay. So the place was now, what do you call it, the room that Baba was using now, it was there's space for us now, for us to stay there, you know, but because that flat was just, it was a lovely big hall, and the two bedrooms, but they don't belong to this house, what do you call it, this flat where they were staying was Khorshed's parents' house, you know, Khorshed, you know. Anyway, then we stayed there, we went to Quetta after that, and when we arrived at Quetta, Baba came and how our journey was it easy, you know, he would talk, you know, the small talk and ask us how we were all kept well on the journey and all that, it was a comfortable journey, everything, he talks, and then he went back to the mandi. And then what, so every morning Baba had his, he stayed with the mandi always next, you know, our room was a very big room, and in the room, not a stick of furniture. A lovely big carpet, a cotton carpet, you mean cotton, no, I don't know what you call it. A cotton carpet, but this is red, it's not red, it's plain like this ordinary color.
Dari.
Like the one, the hall you have in the Darshan hall. Yes, in the Darshan hall. But it's a very large car. All our beddings are rolled up. In the night we roll it open, and then the morning, that was our bedding. Anyway, Baba every morning had his bath in the Mandli's quarters, in the bathroom there, and he would come and we were on the, in the room, and we looked up, Baba was in the doorway, look, Baba looks so beautiful, his hair open on his shoulders, and his white sadra, you know, clean sadra, and he was coming in, but to look at him, to look at him in the doorway was very beautiful, he looked, and so we were all looking at him, and Baba came and sat down on the little carpet that was his seat, and a cushion at the back, and Baba told Adi's mother, Gulmai, to comb his hair. And then he called his girls, you know, we were only three of us at that time. Naja, Khorshed is Baba's sister-in-law, his big brother's wife, and myself, only three girls we were. And then amongst the women, there was Baba's aunt, my mother, Gulmai, that is Adi's mother. And then, so now, Baba said, your girls come and sit here in front of me. So we all came and said, Baba said, what prayers do you pray, you know, Baba asked. And so we said, what we prayed. Baba said, oh, only that much you prayed, you know. You bring your pad and pencil, take down the prayers that I dictate to you. Oh, we were so happy. We quickly went and got a pencil and pad, and we sat in front of Baba, and we were ready. And Baba dictated the prayer, and then after he finished dictating, he would explain the meaning and talk about this prayer. And then he told Naja to show her pad, as she taken down, write what Baba has dictated the prayer. So he would read what Naja has written, and it was okay, just a mistake or two, Baba corrected and gave it to her. Then cautious pad, Baba took the writing pad and he saw it and gave it back, it was okay. And he asked me to... The fun was that I had no practice in writing Gujarati. Mm-hmm. Because we were all the time in English school, you know, the Convent of Jesus and Mary in Pune. We were as boarders when my father was living. After my father died, then we were day scholars. So we were all the time in the convent school, but it was good that our elders had thought about this, that these girls are learning English and they know only English language, they must know how to read and write in Gujarati, this is our language and they must know. So a tutor was kept. Won't you sit down? Yes. There's space here also.
Sit here.
Yes. Okay. That's right. So, our elders had arranged for a tutor to teach us Gujarati in in the evening. So when we came from school before that, we were so happy. But we can't go to the kitchen without washing our hands and feet and face, everything, and then must go to the kitchen and have a light, snack. You make it, yes, because we were hungry and all that. So we would go to the kitchen and our aunt would give us something nice to eat and all that. Then we would wash hands and we rushed to the garden and play and all that. We didn't care about lessons, we wanted to play first, you know, and all that. No, but this time what happened was, I tell you, yes, so now the tutor was arranged for to come and teach us. On the front veranda, our family was always the back veranda where the kitchen is, dining room is, and that side. But on the front, they not much use that. And there was no need to use the front veranda. So the tutor would be waiting on the front veranda. And when we came by, we saw the tutors. We had just finished schooling, and now we have to learn the Gujarati lessons also. It was too much. We were also tired and hot, and we had enough of, you know, learning at school. And again, we have to start learning Gujarati lessons. It was too much for us. But we had to learn. So it was good that we did learn for a short time. Just we finished learning the preparatory book, you know, preparatory ABCD in Gujarati, ABCD, all that. And then the first book comes. So we just had finished learning the first book. And by that time, this tutor was no more coming. He didn't come anymore. It happened. So it was good we had learned just that much. So I knew how to write. But I didn't have practice all these years. I just gave up writing or reading in Gujarati. I had no need to. Anyway, we were still busy learning in the English schools, and then my sister wanted me to learn the piano. So I was learning piano. I liked to play the piano. I saw my sister playing piano, so I liked it. And we had the piano at home. So then after a few days, my sister says, "No, you can't just learn piano. You can't play piano well unless you know the theory. You must learn the theory." I said, "My dear, what to do? I didn't want to learn anything more." But now she's telling me to learn the theory. That was too much for me, because I was struggling with my class lessons in my classroom in school, and now I have to learn the piano theory. And what do you think? My Saturday and Sunday, which I had, you know, a holiday, now my Saturday was cut. You know, half day went in learning theory. So in the morning, on Saturdays also, we had to go to the convent. So far, it was nearly 2 miles. We walked there just to learn the theory. So anyway, I had agreed, and we learned. Yes, I'll come to that. Anyway, then what I want to tell you is that's now we end this thing. I gave a piano practical exam and I passed in that, somehow I scraped through. And the theory exam I gave, but I got 95 out of 100, so that was something. Well, anyway, but somehow I had to leave that school because my sister finished that school. She finished examination of Cambridge. So that school was very far from our home and all that, and some other reason also. My mother didn't want me to come walking alone here. So I had to go to a nearer school that was situated near our house, St. Helena's. So there I go. Now that's another story. I'll tell you about what happened with Baba in Quetta. So Baba took my writing pad out of my hand and he said, "What, you haven't finished writing the prayer? It's only 2 lines written." Yes, Baba said, "You've written only 2 lines." I said, "Yes, Baba, I can't write very fast because I don't have practice in writing Gujarati." He says, "What? Your parents didn't teach you Gujarati?" I said, "No, Baba, we were schooling, English school in the convent of Jesus and Mary, and I didn't go to Gujarati school, have very little practice writing Gujarati, and so I couldn't write fast enough." So Baba said, "All right, give me your pad and pencil." So I quickly gave him the pad and pencil.